Today, we're going to talk about a really cool tool called Hamina Planner, and I'm going to demonstrate a live wireless and network design for an office floor plan. Hamina Planner is used for planning out Wi-Fi coverage and network cabling. So imagine that you're given a floor plan for a building and you need to figure out where to place access points for ideal coverage. Hamina's got a bunch of tools built in that do just that, and it's really powerful in that you can get super granular with its settings to try to get it as accurate as possible to the real-world environment. In this video, I'm going to talk about how Hamina Planner stacks up against similar tools. We're going to talk about pricing, and then I'm going to actually go through a wireless and network design so that you can see how it works. All right, we've got a lot to cover, so let's get started. All right, so this is not a sponsored video. I want to be clear about that up front. No one at Hamina is going to be checking out this video or reviewing it or approving it before I release it. However, Hamina did give me the license for their software for free, so do whatever you want with that information. And by the way, if you're not interested in the details of the pricing or the licensing, check out the chapters down in the description and you can skip forward right to the actual live demo. But let's start by talking about pricing. Hamina Planner is not cheap. So there's basically three components to the full Hamina suite of tools. You've got Hamina Planner, which is what I'm going to show you in this video. And then you've got Hamina OnSite, which also works in conjunction with the Osium Nomad, which is a hardware device. So while Hamina Planner lets you upload a floor plan and then, you know, draw in your walls and windows and then drag and drop access points onto the floor plan to simulate your wireless coverage, Hamina OnSite is for an actual site survey at the actual location, right? This is where you upload a floor plan and then you physically walk around that building doing a wireless site survey with the Osium Nomad to measure the Wi-Fi in real life. All these tools work hand in hand to provide your customers with both projected and actual wireless coverage information. All right, so what's this all gonna cost you if you wanna invest in this solution? The Osium Nomad device for on-site wireless surveys is about $1,700. And then the Hamina Planner Plus and the on-site annual license is $2,340. So basically you're looking at just over $4,000 for the first year and then $2,340 per year recurring. And you might be saying, wait a minute, why would I buy into Hamina Planner when you can just use like the UniFi Design Center tool for free? Doesn't it do all the same stuff? Well, you can use the UI Design Center if you're only ever working with UniFi gear. But what if your customer needs Cisco equipment or Ruckus or TP-Link, right? Hamina Planner works with dozens of different manufacturers and hundreds of different access point models, and it also works hand in hand with the actual on-site survey information. Now, the other main competitor for this type of like robust wireless design tool is Ekahau, but Hamina is about half the cost of Ekahau. It's half the cost of Ekahau. Their Sidekick 2, like their wireless survey device, is $5,000 just for the device. And their software license is another $5,500 with annual renewal fees that are close to $2,000 per year. Or in other words, it's well over $10,000 for the equivalent Ekahau setup. And actually, it's kind of hard to get pricing because Ekahau doesn't publish the pricing on their website. You actually have to buy their stuff through distributors. So if you are in the market for actual professional tools for wireless surveys and wireless planning and design, I think Hamina is kind of like the sweet spot between the like limited, low cost and free options and then the super crazy expensive options. I should mention that they do have Hamina Planner Lite, and it's pretty limited, but it is free if you want to, you know, just play around with Hamina and test it out for yourselves. Okay, so let's go ahead and do an actual wireless design with Hamina Planner. Now, there is also Hamina OnSite, which works in conjunction with the wireless survey tool, the Osium Nomad, where you can walk around and actually measure a building live. If that's something you guys are also interested in, let me know down in the comments and I can maybe do a video on that one as well. But for Hamina Planner, we start with a blank slate here and we want to drag and drop in a floor plan. So we're going to click the button here. And what I have is the floor plan from The Office, the TV show The Office. So you guys might recognize this. And what it's going to do first is going to auto-scale it. And it's going to automatically detect all of the walls and doors based on the floor plan. So as soon as we've uploaded it, notice we can just click on 3D and boom, there we already have all of the walls and doors, and it's done a pretty good job already. Notice it also detected like an elevator over here. Okay, so going back to 2D, now you can of course also do all of your own walls if you want. So like here's the auto detected walls, drywall heavy, wooden doors, and elevator, right? So it found those three things automatically. But you can also come over here to draw, and you can draw in your own stuff as well, and you can get super granular with all of these different materials. So we can click on the filter here. You can see concrete, cubicle, door, glass, metal, wooden, drywall, drywall heavy, etc. And then within each of these, you've got all of these various options for even like the attenuation, like how does it affect signals at 5 gigahertz and things like that. So if you have that information, you can absolutely use it. But for us, we're just gonna stick with the auto-drawn walls for this particular deployment. And then if we come down here to access points, we can actually have like this AI tool that will auto-plan the access points. So we can go ahead and try that. So let's do auto-plan APs. And then here we need to pick which access points we want to use. So if we drop down the manufacturer list, here's where, notice there's just like dozens and dozens and dozens of different brands of access points that you can choose from. So let's pick like a TP-Link here, and then we'll pick a, let's pick like the 653, which is a very standard like Wi-Fi 6 access point. You can choose how it's mounted. You can choose the height. Like, so for example, if you've got higher ceilings, you might want to set the height specifically. And then you can get even more granular with like transmit power at different bands and, you know, which switches it's connected to. We'll get to the switches in a minute. But let's go ahead and do start the auto plan. And again, this is gonna go through and place in a bunch of access points. Now, in this case, I don't really agree with all of this. Now, first of all, we don't need to cover this area over here. There's too many access points, let's put it that way, right? But notice that it did like look at the 2.4 gigahertz channels. Like it turned this channel off for 2.4 gigahertz for the one above Aaron's desk. And then we've got 6, 1, and 11. 2.4 gigahertz is off over here, off, and then 6, right? So if we look at the 2 gigahertz coverage, it was even smarter enough to say like, hey, we're gonna put in a bunch of access points, but we know that that's way too much for 2 gigahertz, so we're gonna disable 2 gigahertz on like basically half of these access points. And then the other ones were spread out equally amongst the different 2.4 gigahertz channels. But in my design, I think this is too many access points, so I'm gonna delete some of these. Let's get rid of this one here. We'll delete that one. I think we're gonna go with just 2. I think 2 is probably appropriate for this design, but we'll make them a little bit more centered here. Let's get rid of this one here. And we'll put that one right there. And finally, we'll ditch this one over here. So even with 2 access points, if we had one sort of in this back area, then you got your break room, you got one over here in the front area, sort of centered above all of these cubicles. If we look at the coverage for everything, 5 gigahertz coverage looks pretty good. So we're not covering the stairwell, we don't kind of get outside the elevator area, and the bathroom's a little bit spotty, but that's okay for 5 gigahertz because on 2.4, we should be well covered across almost this entire floor plan. And again, we can look at this in the 3D view, which is also pretty nice. Now, one thing that you can do once you've set out your access points, you can also check out the roaming. Let me turn off the coverage. Now you see this little guy down here, client view? We can take our client and we can drop a client. Let's say they're using an iPhone, it's 6 gigahertz capable, and we can even set their height and stuff, right? But we're just gonna drop this client right here in the front, and we can see that they are connected at 2.4 gigahertz out in this area, and then we can start actually walking them through this floor plan. And they go through the break room, they get over here to like Kelly's area, and look at that, boom, they just roamed, they just switched to 5 gigahertz on this access point. So you can kind of simulate what someone's experience is as they're walking around a floor plan, and you can see where they would switch to different bands and where they would roam to different access points. Like if we come up over here to the, you know, the stairwell, it might be different than the front office area. So that's kind of a cool feature. Not super impressive when you only have two access points, but if you have a larger floor plan, it works really well. And Hamina does allow you to do multi-floor layouts. So you can upload multiple floor plans and then line them up to the other floor plans, or you can just duplicate this floor plan as a second, third, fourth floor, whatever. And it does take into account the bleeding of access points between the different floors. All right, so we've got our two access points. What about other network equipment? Let's see what we've got here. So we can add in some other pieces of network gear. Now I'm gonna use Ryan's little closet here as where we would put the network gear. That seems like kind of the obvious spot. And let's call this, so let's bring up some switches here. We'll say we have like a 48 port switch here. And it's gonna have 48 ports with a 500 watt PoE budget. And let's drop that right there. And then let's drop another one also right there, because I think we're gonna have enough for, I would want two 48 port switches in this deployment. And then let's also drop in a router, and we'll go with like the ER707M2. That's a great little router from TP-Link, but it does only have four ports and it has no PoE on it. But we will drop that into the same closet right here. All right, so a couple switches and a couple of routers we've added in right here. So now let's start adding in some of our client devices, right? So typically what I like to see is two drops at every desk. You've got a drop for the voice over IP phone, you've got a drop for the PC, and even if you're running the PC through the voice over IP phone, that gives you plenty of extra drops for other equipment like printers or whatever else you might need. So if we go to wired clients here, we got cameras as well. So let's start with cameras. And let's go to, we're gonna set these to a specific switch. So we'll set it to the first 48 port switch. I'm gonna want a camera over here that's kind of covering this front entrance. I'm gonna want a camera on the stairwell entrance, and then we'll put a camera back over here for the back area as well. Basically, we just wanna cover all of our entrances with surveillance. And notice what it did here is it drew in lines for each of these devices. That's gonna be the cabling. So it's estimating sort of like the shortest run or the shortest path to the switch that it's connected to. And at the end of all this, it'll tell us approximately how much cabling we're gonna need for this entire install. But now let's grab some computers, and we'll also put these ones to the first 48 port switch. These don't need any power though, so we'll give one to Aaron, and we'll just sort of start sprinkling in a bunch of computers here because everyone's gonna need one. I'll put two in the conference room, give one to Ryan in the closet, and then over here, we're gonna switch to the other switch for the other side of the office here. All right, let's also do desk phones. So I'm gonna start on the second switch here. And we'll put a desk phone at everyone's desk. Okay, so that we have all those devices in, but like the cabling is crazy, right? It's all over the place. So in a standard drop ceiling environment, you might have cable trays to actually run those cables neatly around the office. So let's now add in some cable trays as well. So from the main point, the main office area here, we're just gonna assume there's a cable tray that goes all the way over here. And then maybe we've got something that branches off up towards Michael's office. Maybe we've got one that branches off here up towards the conference room. And then we're also gonna do another one back over here towards this area, and then maybe we'll run it up that way. All right, so we added in some cable trays. Now what that did is it automatically took all those cables that were spread all around and it puts the cables in the nearest cable tray as part of our plan as well. Okay, so now we can see our plan has come together quite nicely. And if we click up here, we can look at our bill of materials And of course, all of this is customizable with actual equipment and notes and stuff like that, but we can see our switches, how much Ethernet cable, like over 2,500 feet of Ethernet cable, how many cameras, computers, desks, phones, etc. And we can also create a report that we can actually share with the customer and upload our logo, and then they actually get a live view where the customer can actually come in here and also see the wireless coverage like that. So the customer can actually see the different 5 gigahertz and 2.4 gigahertz coverage as well, because you're sending them a live link that shows them all of this sort of stuff. All right, so there you go, a live demo of Hamina Planner. I hope you guys enjoyed that, and let me know what you think down in the comments. Also, let me know what tools you like to use for this kind of wireless network design. I'd love to hear about it. Hamina Planner isn't really like the right tool if you're just trying to plan out devices for your house, for your home network, right? But if you're doing this kind of stuff professionally, it is a tool that really, really comes in handy. Okay, if you'd like to keep this party going, I have hand-selected a couple of videos on the right here for you to watch next. The top video is my recent review of the new GLINET KVM over IP devices. Those are pretty cool. You're going to want to check those out. And the bottom video is my test video for the new Starlink standby mode.